Ben has asked a question, which I think is quite an interesting question. He has asked, which is worse, an Alpine Fault event or a Hikurangi Subduction Zone event? So, Kate, would you be able to answer that question?
Yeah. So, typical scientist answer, it depends. It depends on where you are and how you're measuring sort of the impact of the earthquake. So, by almost all measures, if you're on the west coast of the South Island in an Alpine Fault earthquake, you would be far worse affected by an Alpine Fault earthquake than a Hikurangi Subduction Zone earthquake. The opposite's true. If you're in the North Island, particularly anywhere along the east coast, a Hikurangi Subduction Zone earthquake is going to be significantly worse for you. And kind of the bigger picture, if you're measuring it by impact, well, size of earthquake, firstly, the Alpine Fault is about 500 kilometres long. The Hikurangi Subduction Zone is quite a bit longer. It's about 700 kilometres long, so it has the potential to have much larger earthquakes. And earthquakes on the Hikurangi Subduction Zone, can affect a much larger area, and there's significantly more population in the North Island that would feel that earthquake. And the Hikurangi Subduction Zone is also very likely to trigger a large tsunami as well. So by the kind of measure of how many people would be affected and sort of secondary effects like tsunami, a Hikurangi Subduction Zone is probably going to be much worse. And in terms of just because of the number of people and the infrastructure in the North Island, if you look at it in terms of economic impact, a Hikurangi Subduction Zone is also probably going to be worse than an Alpine Fault earthquake.